Well, they always say it's 40 gallons a set to a single gallon
40
of syrup.
40 to 50, depending on the
35 to 50 gallons of sap. Make
40 gallons of sap.
It's about 40 on the average.
32 gallons. Yeah, 32 gallons goes, one goes, say, one for syrup.
Yeah, so 32 to 1.
Yeah.
As I pour this sap into the pail here, you can see it pretty much just looks like straight water coming out of the tree. And for the most part it is. Gotta zoom in from the top there. You can see all those bubbles. That shows that there's a little bit of sweet in this water. The sap is basically, on an average tree, it's about 2% sugar in the water that the trees are pulling out of the ground. And when we boil the sap down to make maple syrup, that's why it takes about, you know, they say anywhere from 35 to 50 gallons of sap to make a gallon of syrup, and that depends on how sweet your trees are. You might have a tree right down by the stream, say, that's got a full bucket in it, but that doesn't necessarily mean it's good, because it could just be mostly water, and then you're spending more time boiling it off. So there's a lot of science to it, but the great thing about it is there's a lot of mystery still no one knows really about.
As far as sugar in here, you know, how do we know when the sap's going to be flowing good, if which direction the wind's blowing? I mean, right now, you know, wind's coming from...
The old red, white, and blue is telling us what?
Let's see, we're coming from... that's about north about that way. It's coming from the east, right?
Roughly, a little bit.
Southeast.
Well, I don't know. These old-timers always used to tell me that when the wind came from the north, the sap runneth forth.
Yeah.
Wind from the east, sap runneth least.
Yeah.
Wind from the south, it run like a drouth.
Yeah.
And wind from the west,
it run the best.
Yeah.
But I don't quite figure out what a drouth is.
Well, look, D-R-O-T-H, look it up. It's not running at all.
Yeah.
The process couldn't be simpler, really. You get a pan, you light a fire underneath it, you put the sap in it, and it just boils and boils and boils until all the water leaves, and you're left with sugar, you're left with syrup.
He could boil all day, but sit on his bucket half the time and just relax, you know. And others are nervous and running around like me when I first used to do it nights and so forth, you know. I'd be a nervous wreck running around, always running around looking, you know, and checking, you know.
Yeah.
Pancake maker.
I do have some sandwiches. I got some coffee on board too. We ought to have a cup of coffee here.
They might not like it the way you fix it.
Well, it's with cream and sugar, or cream and sweetener anyway. No?
Woo-hoo.
That's what it's
you can
to
smell
be.
It though.
Yeah, you sure can. You smell
it. Woo! You don't want to get downwind of that, Rob.
Hey, would you like a Saturday night bath?
No, it's serious.
This setup that we have in this sugar house, sap's coming in from that holding tank out there. Then here you can control how much is coming in. It's good to try and keep it coming in at just kind of about what you're boiling off. But since I just drew off some of this sweet, I'm kind of letting it flow in pretty good. What we do is we take it once it's boiled off, gets back here, it's getting sweeter and sweeter. Then we take some of it and we put it into this finishing pan over here, which is what will actually boil it down and turn it into the maple syrup in this pan. And I just keep it about 2 inches, transfer it over, just keep it going. You see the sap starting to get a little bit darker, a little richer color there as we boil it off that water, which is the steam kind of leaving the sugar house right now. And it's too bad you can't smell it in here right now, because this is one of the reasons why the sugar, the
the bathed scent of this steam, which is just pretty much the sweet of the earth and the spring leaving here. And it's almost like having a pancake breakfast just wrapped around you in goodness, but it's not as intense as syrup. It's really mild, really just a genuinely beautiful, beautiful smell.
Then you move up a generation to my namesake, Chet. There's Chester.
Okay.
Now, see if you can see what I mean by the resemblance.
Yeah, you got the same nose, that's for sure, yeah. Jim.
Same divot in the nose, but you can't see that.
You can kind of see how it comes. You can see a little bit of the bump there, but...
He was a character not unlike myself, you know, in a lot of ways. Yeah.
Wasn't hard to work for at all, huh?
Yeah, he was hard to work for, all right.
It doesn't generally work that way. You need these changes in the atmosphere, pressure, and, you know, storms and wind and snow and spells of cold and wet and you freeze to death, you know. That seems to be what spurs the sap rushing to the buds of the trees. You know, there's a lot about it that no one will ever understand.
When it gets down to 20 at night and 40, 45 in the daytime, that's perfect. It don't stop too early in the morning, but it'll really run when it does.
But I've never set up a pipeline, I've never worked with it, but from what I understand of it, I don't really have much interest in working a pipeline. Just a lot of hassle, a lot of stuff to stretch out. I don't know, there's something about the buckets that I just like. You know, you just know it's sugar season, they're getting close, and that means you know it's getting close to spring and summer when you're driving down the road and you're seeing rows and rows of maple trees tapped right on the edge of the street there, buckets hanging off of them, a couple buckets hanging on each one sometime. I don't know, it's just kind of a reward, you know, end of winter, you know, summer's coming, you know, you made it through when you see those buckets put out on the road.
They tried to time spring school vacation to sugar. You'd have a 2-week vacation that was called sugaring vacation, not spring. So the kids could help out in the sugar.
Rather be sitting in a deck chair high up over Kansas City on a genuine old-fashioned authentic steam-powered airplane.